The Obama administration has greenlit the deployment of a small group of U.S. elite troops to the northern part of Syria, this to keep fighting the Islamic State. We're talking about less than 50 elite troops that are going to go support and coordinate local ground forces in the fight against Syria. This is in Kurdish controlled territories, Nick, and it's obviously an escalation of the same strategy that we've been doing. A president that said, I'm not going to put boots on the ground on Syria. Now we see that we are deploying these special forces that are going to go do very precise work, helping the not the training like in the past, but the actual warfare that is going on the ground.
Right, that training in the past. I mean, yeah. what did we get out of that? Four or five soldiers that we said were deemed, you know, good enough to fight alongside us. Now, look, I mean, we just saw recently in Iraq, we saw the raid by the Delta Force where we freed all those ISIS captives. And after that, the military kind of said, we're going to be seeing a lot more of these. And that kind of hinted at something like this, whether it's, we're going to call them night raids, whether they're going to call them aides, whatever we're going to call these soldiers that are on the ground, it's boots on the ground, and they're just reluctant to say it.
Yeah, and what we're talking about is this use of special forces instead of larger deployments like we saw back in Iraq and Afghanistan. Now we traded for this idea of sending smaller groups of elite forces that go and take care of raids, take care of a specific kind of a quarterback type of position where they go and they organize the people that is facing the perils. Now, what we know is that we have the special forces operating in 147 countries around the world. This is 75% of the countries around the world. At some point, they have U.S. special forces doing a mission in their territories. That's
right.
pretty intense.
And this territory that they've chosen, northern Syria, that's very strategic, right? We don't want ISIS to get any closer and start to spill over into Turkey, right? Turkey's very important for us because that is the gateway into Europe. Now, what is this going to mean for ties with Turkey, for example? I mean, we know that the Turkish government are fighting with the Kurds. They hate the Kurds. They see them as terrorists. So what does that mean that we're now working with the Kurds, meanwhile allies with the Turks? Very complicated. This is a sticky situation. And it's very messy.
Well, the Obama administration actually thought about that international kind of pool relation that happens, and they actually also authorized operation deployments in Jordan and Lebanon and the deploying of A-10 and F-15 attack aircraft in the Turkish airbase that they have. So at the same time, they did support the Kurdish militia and also reinforce the relationship with Turkey. Like you mentioned, it's very important. And also, Turkey is one of the places where ISIS is starting to take a little more of a stronghold and is the most critical connection in between the West and the East. Also, how do we feel about this? Do we feel like Obama at the end is caving and saying, well, maybe we did, you know, we should have gone there earlier and have more presence now that Putin is actually taking the initiative?
Knowing that people are going to say that. Now, Ash Carter has come out numerous times and he said, ladies and gentlemen, the strategy has not changed. It's the same thing. We are training. This is training purposes only. Now, aside from that, though, I think if we're going to look at a broader sense of everything, I think what's important to realize is that now we have the Saudis, the Iranians, the Americans, the Russians all coming together and talking at the same table in Vienna. I think that's going to make some change. Maybe not immediately, but the fact that they're coming together and hopefully willing to come back together next coming few days, I think that says a lot in itself.
Yeah, what is known that is that actually in those negotiations, they said that they are looking at eventually have a ceasefire, also have a political transition. You know, Russia, obviously, they don't want Assad to leave power because it's in their benefit, but they are willing to negotiate and they're coordinating as much as possible with the U.S. this strike so we don't end up with a U.S.-Russia proxy war happening on the ground on Syria using proxy players.
Right. Although, at the same time, though, even the Iranians, the Russians, no one said, you know, we don't ever want Assad to leave. No one's saying that. It's kind of an argument. Should there be fair elections with Assad as a part of it? Should he not be able to take part? I think even the Russians are saying, hold on, we're not saying he needs to stay in power forever, but let's get this mess sorted out, and then we'll worry about it. The only way we're going to get through this mess is if we work with the only ground troops that are backed by an actual legitimate government, and that's Assad's people.
Correct. Well, we want to know your opinion. Share your thoughts below in the comment section, and if you haven't, please subscribe to the Leap TV.